Hello friends, and welcome to the second tutorial in the series of spoken tutorials on Python for scientific computing. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to obtain basic plots using a set of points. We plot experimental data more often than we plot mathematical curves. So here, we shall learn how to plot experimental data. You can input the data either as a list or read from a plain text or a binary file. We shall cover both one by one. Please make sure you have the pendulum.txt file as mentioned on the requirement list of the session. As you can see, the pendulum.txt file in our case is on the desktop and we are currently in the home directory. So we navigate to the desktop using cd desktop. Now let's start IPython by typing ipython space hyphen pylab. First, we shall look into using lists to input the data and then we shall plot it. Type x equal to open square bracket 0, comma 1, comma 2.1, comma 3.1, comma 4.2, comma 5.2, close the bracket. Here, x is a list. In Python, list is a container that holds a number of objects in the given order. We shall look into other functions related to list a little later. Now, for the corresponding y values, we type y equal to open square bracket 0, comma 0.8, comma 0.9, comma 0, comma minus 0.9, comma minus 0.8, and close the square bracket. Now that we have x and y in two separate lists, we plot x versus y using plot x, comma y, comma within quotes O and hit enter. And lo, we have our plot. The O within the quotes plots with filled circles. Now that we know how to plot data from lists, we'll look at plotting data from a text file. Essentially, if we read the data from the file and fit them into lists, we can easily plot the data, just as we did previously. Here, we shall use the data collected from a simple pendulum experiment as an example. The aim of the experiment is to plot the length versus the square of the time period of a simple pendulum. Let us check out what pendulum.txt contains. Type cat pendulum.txt. Windows users just double click on the file to open it. Please be careful not to edit the file. The first column is the length of the pendulum and the second is the time period. We read the file line by line, collect the data into lists and plot them. Let us begin with initializing three empty lists for length, time period and the square of the time period. T equal to open and close square brackets. L equal to open and close square brackets. TSQ equal to open and close square brackets. Initializing an empty list is done as shown above, using just a pair of square brackets without any content in them. Now we open the file and read it line by line. For line in open, within quotes, within parenthesis, name of the file, in this case pendulum.txt, colon. Note that the colon at the end of the for statement marks the beginning of the for block. Open returns an iterable object which we traverse using the for loop. In Python, for iterates over items of a sequence. For more details regarding the for loop, refer to our tutorial on loops and data structures. Whatever we read from a file is in the form of a string. Thus, line here is a string variable that contains one line of the file at a time as the for loop iterates through the file. We split each line at the space using point equal to line dot split. The split function returns a list of elements from the line variable split over spaces. In this case, it will have two elements. First is the length, second is the time period. Point here contains two elements. The first one is the length and the second is the time period. Note the indentation here. Everything inside the for loop has been indented by four spaces. Then we append the length and the time period values to the appropriate list. Since we cannot perform mathematical operations on strings, we need to convert the strings to floats before appending to the list. L.append within parenthesis float of point of within square brackets 0. Similarly, T.append within parenthesis float of within parenthesis point within square brackets 1. Append is a function used to append a single element to a list. That's it. Now we need to exit the loop. So hit enter twice. Now we have the time and length values in two lists. In order to get the square of the time values for each of the values in the time period list, we shall write one more for loop which will iterate through the list t. For time in t colon tsq dot append within parenthesis time star time. Hit enter twice to exit the loop. Let us now verify if L, T and TSQ have the same number of elements. Type print len of L, comma, len of T, comma, len of TSQ and hit enter. Now we have verified that all three have the same dimensions. List L and TSQ have the required data. Let us now plot them as we did earlier. Plot L, comma, TSQ, comma, within quotes O. So here is the required plot. We may proceed to label the axis, title the plot, save it and do whatever else we want. In this tutorial, we have learnt so far how to create lists, append items to them. We have learnt how to process data using lists, how to open and read files and the for loop. That brings us to the end of this session. Hope this information was helpful to you. Thank you.